Hi, today I have another challenge for you. So if you want, you can do this, what I will show you now, every day, right after you wake up. This is what I like to do. I don't do it every day, but when I do it, I think my day is more grounded and I'm more happy all over. So this has something to do with your feet, and it's for your feet health, for your feet beauty, and for your feet happiness. So it's like a mixture of a massage and also a little workout, but it's not longer than 5 minutes. You just need 5 minutes for both feet. So don't worry, I will show you now what I do. So normally I just sit on the top of my bed, and then I take one foot up on my leg and I just start by rubbing it. I rub it to get warm, and whatever you do with your feet, don't do it harsh and don't do it with like an external power. Have a feeling of it coming all from your pelvis and going through your arms and coming from like your pelvis and your heart, and do it with love. So the most important thing is focus on your feet with love and care. You don't need any lotion. You just wake up and take your feet in your own hands. So after you have done this, you just do something like this. Just go with the thumbs from the inside to the outside. You can just do what feels good. After you have done this, you take all your toes down, and your foot isn't like this, it's straight. And then you just scratch from the toes up. This feels beautiful. Good. And then you take your toes up and down, up and down. This takes a little practice to feel really good, but when you practice it every day, it will feel better and better every day. So after you have done this with all your toes, you just go one toe after the other. First the big one, then the second one. Do it a few times. You can count it, or you just play this video when you wake up and do it with me. And then the fourth toe, just up and down. I take the toes between my two fingers, pointing and middle finger, and then just go up and down. And I bend them as far as possible out, and I curl them as far as possible in. So it's not just the big joint, it's all small joints. This one is only two joints, but they have three joints. And you want to move all three joints. So it's like really curling in and then going out as far as possible. So something like this. Good. And when you have done this with all the toes, then you take your, if it's your right leg, your right hand here on the heel, and the left one takes all the ball, the whole balls. And then you turn the ball in, while the heel goes out. And while you do this, you focus on this part to shorten. So we want to shorten. Don't do it point, do it flex. This is very important. And everything you do, really focus here with your mind on what you do, and focus really on the foot, and be really with your heart and mind, with your lovely foot. So this is really a great, great part of this exercise, to do it really consciously, mindfully and sensuous. So really feel everything you do. After you have done this 10 times, you can stand your foot right on your bed. You can do everything also sitting down. And then you take your toes and pull them out. You will feel it feels really good. And then you take your fingers and point them here right inside while you take the thumbs, the knuckles of the thumbs, and write them around down. So this one we have done for building this bridge. And this one, this arc, and this one we do for building this arc. Because there are two arcs that tend to go flat with nearly everybody. Some people are the other direction, but most of us are flat-footed and flat here also on the ball. So every arc has crushed and then we walk like this. When we do these exercises, you will really feel that you can walk differently, really, really differently. So after you have done this for a time, you take your foot again here. You can repeat this exercise because this is really beautiful. This is what my shiatsu teacher told me. Wonderful woman. So all the exercises that I'm doing, some are for me, but some are from Spiraldynamik, this is the German brand, and some are from Shiatsu, from my beautiful Shiatsu teacher Lulu, that is also a beautiful Shiatsu massagist and body worker, and my Feldenkrais teacher Heidi Fichtner, that is also an amazing, wonderful woman. She has showed me the following exercise. So you take your balls and then you isolate every toe. You go front and back, front and back. And this really involves, I don't know if you see my muscles are working, a lot of power. And you see that your foot will get more and more flexible. And the more flexible your foot is, the better for your whole body as well. All the feet have reflex zones all over them. And they are also better in balancing everything, even in high heels. So when you're wearing high heels, like I love to do, but it's not good for your health. But when you do this, you can also improve your foot health and wear more high heels. So, and then you go through every part. This is really beautiful exercise. And then one that is also beautiful, you take your toe and pull it out while circling in and out. You turn it in, out. You rotate. And you can feel how far you can feel your foot. You really get a good notion of your anatomy, of your foot anatomy. And then the middle toe, you will feel every toe is different and you will get to know your body more and more. And it's so, so good, it's so important. Really feel what you are feeling with your hands and what you are feeling with the foot that is getting this nice massage. And if you don't like doing like this, you can find other ways of working. Just find ways for working with your feet that are not feeling hard on your body. So if you feel this is not comfortable, then change. You should always feel comfortable and relaxed. So after you have done this, shake your foot out. Beautiful. And then you can put it on the floor. When you do another exercise from Spiraldynamik, you think of these two points. Grounding into the floor and this bridge on arching. Then you do this exercise for And here you don't want to make something like this, to grip with your toes. You want to leave them as relaxed as possible. And check it out. And now two other nice points from Shiatsu. And this is the K1 point for the liver, for the kidneys, and for increasing your energy flow. If you believe it or not, try it out, it's really fascinating. And then another nice point, this one. I think it's for the ovaries. I don't know it now, but I will post it for you in the description. And then you can check it out again. So now we will just see how the feet feel. Oh my god, yes, completely different. So I don't know where you are. Let's see. So my feet feel completely different. This one is really all, it has received a lot of love. The whole side feels really good. And this one is still a little bit poor. So I will repeat this whole section with the left foot. And if you want, just take one or two of these exercises that you like the most and do them every day. And if you like to do it all at once, just practice the whole routine. It's a very nice routine, and then you can incorporate it in your daily life. Oh, and while I'm here, I will also show you a nice thing that I have already shown you in the cool down for my belly dance workouts. And this one is so good. You roll on your toes, front and back, front and back. This is nicely stretching then. Good. I could go on for hours. I love working with the feet, but I don't want to make this video longer than it's already. Okay, so I'm very curious how this works for you. Tell me. And if you want to know more about feet and more footwork that you could do to improve your dancing and your walking and your sensuousness, then just write it also in the comments. I would be very happy to share more with you, because I tell you how it came that I became a foot expert. Because I always loved high heels. So when I was a small girl, I was wearing high heels day and night, dancing all night long in high heels, walking to school, everywhere, shopping, everything in high heels. And I seriously damaged my feet. Then I was a professional dancer, where I also danced all the time on tiptoes, because I loved elegance more than anything else. And I was all the time on tiptoes, and many times I really hurt my the balls of my feet. And one time I practiced so hard that I broke a little part out of this joint. And then I was in the emergency, and then I had different therapies to get this all together again. It was really very, very bad. And the doctor told me, because I had my foot was like this, my doctor told me to get an operation. And then I said, at my age, I can't imagine this is not possible. I think there is a way to train the feet to get them back in a nice position, because after all, they are bones, muscles, sinews. So if I can work out my spine, like I have worked out my spine with the scoliosis and everything, and if I can work on my eyes, then I should also could really work on my feet. And then I started to do research and training, and then I found out how the feet work and how they work best and how they are happy, and how happy feet really increase the happiness of my life. And so now I'm very happy to share it with everybody that comes across my life with sad feet on high heels or whatever. Good. So this was the backstory of the story. And yes, I'm so happy to hear what you think of this. So write a comment below and tell me how it went for you. If you do it every day, if you just took one exercise, tell me everything. I'm so excited. And if you want to know anytime I post a new video, just subscribe to my channel here on YouTube. And if you want to have more beautiful insights delivered into your email inbox, where I share my personal tips and my advice, what I use for myself and what I use for my coaching clients and my students, then just subscribe to my newsletter that I have on my page, sensuousmind.com, where I share everything for free. Good! See you then. Bye bye.